Now we're going to examine the center of mass for the three-dimensional case. So we have a storage shed in the shape of a half cylinder with radius R and L as shown. The shed is filled with sawdust whose density of mass per unit volume at any point is proportional to the distance of that point from the floor. So, they probably meant inversely proportional, because you would think that the mass would be more packed. The sawdust would be packed at the bottom and would get less packed as you rose. But that's not the way they said it. So we're going to go with the way they said it. Okay, so it says the constant of proportionality is K. Calculate the total mass of the sawdust in the shed. So it says a density at a y location going up at any y location off the floor. So, you know, from here to here, for example, from here up to here, at this point straight up, any point off the floor. So all these points along here where I've drawn this sort of slab cut horizontal to the floor, the density is all ky there, proportional to the distance it is from the floor. And if you call this y here, that is the distance from the floor. Okay, so it's ky, and that's some kind of mass per volume units. So we're going to want to calculate the mass of the rectangular slab cut up at the y location. So we're up here at the y location. What's the mass of the rectangular slab cut there? So you go over here, take the face of the picture, and you realize you have a right triangle in there up at a y location. We're going to call this part here A, and of course the radius out here all the way, because it's a semicircle, is R. So you put that into your algebra, solve it out, and it turns out that the A part is this. So the volume of the rectangular slab up at a y location is two of those A's, because A only went halfway. So it's two of those A's times the length. That was width times length. Then we also need height, delta Y. Delta Y. So there's your volume of your rectangular slab. Then you want mass of the slab. It's the density, mass per unit volume, times your volume. The volumes cancel out and you get mass. And that volume is going to be in cubic meters, cubic feet, something like that. And here's your volume. So multiplying those two together and you will get the mass of the slab. Then you want to add up all those slabs from y equals 0 to y equals r. And here we have our summation notation with the delta y in there. That's the Riemann sum. And then the total mass, of course, will be the integral. And we just organize this bit here a little bit better. Factor it out, and here's your integral. And that substitution would handle it, but for the video, we're just going to say, okay, we know what it is because I looked it up on Wolfram Alpha, and the antiderivative is this. So I'm going to just put that in there and evaluate this definite integral using that antiderivative right here. From 0 to r, factor out to 2kl, factor out even the negative 1/3, and then start the substitution of the r and the 0 in there, put them in, and work out all the algebra, and you get this. This is the total mass of the sawdust.